Hey there boys and girls, Lucky here and welcome back to another Overwood video. Today I'm going to show you my favorite flank routes with Tracer right here on Eichenwalde. Alrighty, so the first one's pretty obvious. Just in general in Eichenwalde there are not too many great specific flank routes, but there are a couple of them that you can use. So first of all, I'd always recommend to go out right here, top to the right side, and then just go straight to this point. This way you're not going to be annoyed by any Symmetra turrets or Torbjorn turrets or stuff like that, or Junkrat traps, for example. So you can just go up straight here, get early information about the enemy heroes, then you continue to go over here, and now this is where the trick comes in. You can go over there with one jump like that. With one blink, I mean. However, I usually find once you're here, they already saw you and you're kind of out in the open, so this is kind of a risky thing to do. What I prefer because of that is I blink to the right side of this pole and then to the left into this room right there, for example like this. So like this, I already got cover right here, I got access to the health kit, and I can also just quickly go around, get another health kit, and just flank them from behind. This is probably the most useful flanking route, because if you're going straight through the middle, even if you're trying to go up the stairs, there's just so much like trash damage in here that you usually get caught by something that wasn't really aiming for you. So the flank route above right here is usually the one that will get you through the day the safest. Now, if you're a cheeky defender and not an attacker, you can also sit in this room right here in the beginning, wait until someone is passing right here just by emoting like this, with the city mode for example, so you can actually see behind you if they're going to pass by you, so you can then again flank them from behind, or you can just look in front of you right there and see if anyone is just going into, well, or through the main door, so that's always helpful. However, this is very risky and often can get you killed. So in case you die, I got something else for you as well. Alright, now let's say the last thing we did wasn't really working out as we wanted it to, so you can actually go onto these planks right here, then you use a single blink in combination with a jump, then you get onto this, well, that bastion kind of, like this part of his shoulder, and then do a jump forward and up, and then you just blink once, and you get on top of here. So if you're trying to get back to the point fast, this is actually better because you once again don't have to go through the, well, the hallway beneath you, so there's less possible damage actually attacking you, and you get a nice little hang ground and can just spam on them. Go to the backside of the payload, since they will be usually holding right here once they are on the point, trying to prevent anyone from coming through. So if you actually make the jump over here, get to this point, you can more easily get back to, well, the payload right here, to the capture point and defend it. So that's also kind of nice. Okay, another idea. So let's say you move up right here, you do the same thing, and okay, they captured now the objective. So what you do now, or what you can do, is jump around and blink into this corner, and you actually get stuck in here. So once they're kind of coming out, you can just fire away at them, and they're usually pretty confused. They turn around, but they most likely are not going to look up, and especially if you got a tracer bomb like this, you can just drop it and then just see them explode. That's also kind of cool. Now back to the attacker side. Now if you're just going up this way, right under the bridge, there's certainly a little path to the right down there that you can use. That one's pretty common. There's also the planks over there, which you can reach with a single blink. So again, you just walk on over here, jump and blink. You kind of stay in the air a little while until you reach the same altitude as the initial starting point of your jump, and then you blink and you can get to this one over here. And of course, we want to always preserve our blinks, because our blinks are our, well, bread and butter as Tracer. So that's very handy to do if you're kind of crossing over here and you usually got like an Ana sitting, for example, right here. So you can just do this, start attacking them, flank to this side, and you again have health kits at your disposal right here. So also kind of helpful. Alrighty, so last but not least, we're going to talk about this part of the castle right here. This is the tower right in front of there. So you of course can go up in here if you just walk through the castle, like the mid part. And you want to locate this bastion, like you got usually Widow sitting up here, or Soldier, Hans, or whatever. And you want to just once again jump on it for more height. Then you do a normal single jump, blink, blink, and you're on this part of the platform. Also very handy, you get a high ground again, they have to look up, it's more annoying. You can also easily, or more easily, oh, there's a bird, kill a Pharah that's usually coming out in here, so you just wait for her, or a Widow that's just kind of sitting in the window, and just spam at her right here and kill her. That's also very handy. Of course you can just jump over and blink in there, but it's usually kind of risky to do that, so what I prefer is just go over here, and then I think this is a better spot. You can still easily kill anyone in here, you can recall back to the point, but you can also just more freely fire towards anything. You can jump down here, fire there, go back to this point. So this is also nice to do as Tracer due to your blinks. Alrighty, so the last one. Sadly, I don't really have a proper or nice flank route for this last part of the map. I think it's very, since it's so narrow, there's lots of trash damage that's eventually going to hit you. So what I prefer to do most of the time is I try to either go around the space all the way back in here, like this, so you can go around here, so that you're not as easily visible. And then you can again use either this point, or I usually prefer this one, to blink across and try to get in here. Of course, they usually will see you and they will be prepared for you to come out right there. So you wanna again just cross this and blink very fast or quickly. And you also got a big health kit in here. Not many people notice for some reason, but it's kind of nice to have. And again, it's not like the best or most awesome flank route, but it's still kind of nice. And you can like usually kill soldier on high ground right here, go back, kill Anna back here or Zen. So there's also this, but yeah, not much for the last point sadly. But I hope you still enjoyed the video, and I think that's pretty much all for now. So yeah, I'd say lucky skill faker out.